Thursday. Welcome to a brand new YouTube video. I'm a little bit sad today because we had something scheduled that kind of fell through literally a couple hours before it was supposed to happen. No worries though, we'll take care of it next week, but as soon as I'm able to share with you guys exactly what it is, I will. But just know that it was supposed to happen probably today, and like it would have been like resolved by the end of next week, but it's probably pushed back a couple more days, but no worries. So as you guys know, Thursdays are my deadlift days. It's my third to last workout. So today we're gonna be working up to a heavy single, probably like around 675 to 695 pounds, maybe even 700, depending on how we feel as I'm warming up. It's supposed to be a longer hold at the top to make sure we're emphasizing grip strength. So we're gonna hold it at the top for about 4 seconds, and then after that we have a 3x6, pretty easy. As you can tell, my favorite music's playing. I'm not joking when I say that whenever I step inside of the gym and like I hear something, it just kind of fucks up my whole vibe. I was already kind of struggling to get inside to the gym today. Like I was like, you know what, let me wake up, get this shit out of the way, and then like just kind of like have the rest of the day to myself. And as soon as I walk in and I hear this top music playing, it's just like, it drains all the energy that I had. But we're gonna get to it, man. I hate complaining about music because it's like a repetitive thing on my YouTube channel now, but it is something that is very important to me. Like, the vibes are very important. It's very easy to fuck up the vibes. And when you have Hollister music playing inside of the gym, it definitely affects that vibe. But we're gonna get to it. Shout out to Duhon. Yo, show them the new kicks in the mirror, bro. You gotta show them the whole look. You know what I'm saying? You guys didn't know Duhon only wears Vans, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, these are like your first actual pair of shoes that aren't Vans that I've seen you wear, at least. I don't know. They look good, man. They look good. I was like, damn, dude, I'm walking a little bit different today. Like, why is he walking so confident? Like, he's like, hey, man, you ready to film today? I'm like, damn, dog. I'm like, why are you looking at me like that? I looked down and I was like, oh, shit. Boy, got the pearly whites on. They look good, though, man. But, okay. Put the headphones on. Sip on that little muddy. It's worth it.
Smoke. Dominate choke. Fuck my bro, I'm in the white, let me get in the poke. 100 racks, they gon' take your soul. 100 racks, Glock with a 3 and a O. Glock bought a yacht, put the kids on a boat. Put a brick in the figure of the foe. Got a stick, it's a stick, it'll blow. Mix up a foe, my bitch Margiela on the toe. Dig up a soul, look what I did in the bowl.
Yeah, yeah, dude. I mean, where the fuck should I really even start? I got holes that I'm keeping in the dark. I got my niggas thinking back to the fact that they dead. Thought my raps were the facts, so they sat with the bars. I got two behind me.
Talking to the Rolex wearing, get better today, honcho. Something, something else. Woo! Wheeling, dealing. Woo! So I was listening to this song called, I think it's like, What Should I Do or something like that by Pusha T. And the intro is like that Ric Flair speech. And like I got so hyped up, I was like smiling on my way to that top set. So we hit 680 pounds for a top set, for a top single. And we held it at the top for 4 seconds, gave you that little smile, gave that little at the top, you know what I'm saying? So now we're about to drop down and get that 3x6 out of the way. I feel strong today, so I think 585 pounds, which is 6th place, should be all right for today's workout. So let's get to it. I feel good, like I spent an extended time warming up. I did a lot of dynamic stretching stuff, like running around the gym, doing like my football warm-ups, kind of that kind of vibe. So like I feel warm. Usually I kind of jump into the workout and I'm like a little bit cold and it takes me a longer time to warm up, but I was warm from 7 to 1, so. Let's go! Let's go.
Thank you.
Shit. That was painful on my grip. I don't know how it's on paper, but we got it.
Shit.
Okay, that was a gut check. I'm like, okay, so if you guys didn't know, when it comes to my deadlift session, I actually take a period of time after I finish up deadlift because deadlift is the most taxing movement that I'd say there's in powerlifting. Yeah, for me, it's because that's like more times than not, you're gonna be moving the most amount of weight on deadlift. So it just takes a bigger toll on your body. So I just need a little bit more time to recover. Usually when I finish up with bench, I'm able to just jump into a whole ass bodybuilding workout. But when it comes to deadlift, I have to take a little bit of time, breathe, drink water, use the restroom, wash my hands, clean myself up, and then like get myself back together, then attack my bodybuilding portion of the workout because deadlift fucks me up, man. So we're gonna jump straight into a bodybuilding workout right now. And this is gonna be a workout, number one, that I'm kind of freestyling, but also like we're getting geared up for volume 3 of my power building program series. There was volume 1 at the top of the year, volume 2 in the middle of the year, and now we're having volume 3 to close out the year. I know a lot of you guys have been asking for that. You guys have had some great results on volume 2. So essentially just getting an idea of how I work out. So once again, we wrapped up the heavy compound movement. Now we're moving on to the lighter isolation work to help build that muscle that keeps you nice and swollen healthy. So let's do it. It's gonna be like a real emphasis type workout. So we want that thick back, you know what I'm saying? T-H-I-C-C-C-C-C. You feel me? Okay, let's do it.
Man, let it go. I cut off some friends, where they go? I stick to the plan, that's the goal. Fuck you. Tell Tim Chalamet to come get at me. Skin glowing, clear acne. Diamonds see through, so holographic. Red ones look like Aiden Mackey. Spent the narrow like taxi driver. Handmade is that thing with ties. But I rode the bike and built it behind me. And he got the cannon like he bagged Mariah. Yeah, we straight, but if you wrinkle up the situation, he will go grab the iron. And he see what I do right now. And my bitch makes like Jambalaya. Man, fuck with the fan. We in Japan. Bitch, you a bum, so you don't understand. Yeah, I cut off some friends. See where you been. Bitch, I'm in Bella. Been looking for land. Need a spot in the hills, not the beach. Need a pool just to cool it. I do need the grass, not the sand. But I really do not care the cost. Cause I got what's up, but I got what's up. I'm gonna die.
Let it go. I cut off some.
That was a pretty good back workout. I'm like super sore right now. But that's it for today, man. I just want to get back to the crib. It looks like it's about to rain, so I want to get back to the crib, get some work done. Actually, no, I gotta go to the office, get some work done, then go to the crib, relax. I actually have to pack because I will be spending the weekend in South Texas in the valley. You know what I'm saying? What up? There's gonna be like a dope policy gym that I'm gonna be going over there. I'm gonna be going to while I'm over there. So yeah, I'll catch you guys up tomorrow. My flight's super early in the morning, so that's it. XOXO TTYL. Later, over the HQ, we just got back from the valley area. I'm not sure if you guys know exactly where that's at, but it's called the what is it, the RGV, Rio Grande Valley. So I just got back from visiting my girlfriend over in the valley area. I was gonna vlog it, and then like once I got there, I was just like, I don't feel like vlogging, bro. So basically on Friday, I had a pretty good bench session. I actually hit 365 for 5 reps. And then on Saturday, I had a pretty good squat day, hitting a pause single at 625 pounds and then doing back downs with 545 pounds. But y'all can peep that on my Instagram page if you haven't already. So it's Monday. No, Sunday night right now. We just finished up packaging 95% of the orders for the Get Better Today hoodie and long sleeve launch. So I'm gonna get back inside the lab tomorrow morning and fix all the orders that could not be verified because y'all don't put in the shipping address the way it's supposed to be put in. Let's cut this shit. I'm playing. So sometimes people put in their shipping address like wrong, or maybe like maybe the system gets it wrong and like it just it can't be verified. So I have to go in and manually put it in because like sometimes it just stacks the addresses weirdly. So we'll take care of that tomorrow. But order's done. Shout out to Shali too, man. He had like probably the biggest launch of the year for Naka. So there's like just a lot of shit going on here in the warehouse. Like there's just boxes everywhere. It's hard to walk around. You know what I'm saying? They hate to see it. Actually, no, they love to see it. But I want to thank you guys so much for the support on the launch. Shit, I mean, we got more stuff coming, so I'm excited about that, but I need to get some sleep. So, I'll catch y'all tomorrow. What's up? Welcome to day number... I guess you call it day number two. Yesterday wasn't really a day. It was like a couple of hours because we finished up packaging. But I actually just wrapped up at the office. We're clearly here in the gym right now. About to get it in. So today we have a heavy single on bench at an RPE of 7-8, which means that we are going to be probably creeping into the 400 pound range. Then after that we have a 3x7, it's going to be relatively easy. Then we have a full on chest and back workout because it is Monday, so y'all know the fucking vibes. Y'all know what's going on here. Sipping on that yak, I'm trying to get in the mood. Got good music playing today right now, so I'm just going to probably not put on the headphones, just kind of absorb the vibes, kind of see everyone training, seeing what time they're on. That's one of my favorite things, just kind of seeing like people getting it, because it helps me get motivated to get it too. But let's get to work, man. I feel like today's gonna be a good day. Really good bench day. I ain't gonna lie to you guys, I don't really feel like, I don't know what it is. I just don't feel like kind of in that mood to work out right now. It's weird, like I was talking to Duhan about like kind of the fact that it doesn't feel like a Monday. Usually I start my Mondays off like with a lot of high energy, but this Monday was just a little weird. I don't know, like just, I'm not sure what it is. But we were still able to hit 430 pounds. It was a little bit of an overshoot. It was supposed to be an RPE of 7-8. I think at best I could have got that for another rep, but just being able to come inside the gym and hit 420 last week and then 430 this week is like a win. So, you know, a little bit outside of RPE, but it's fine. Still 4:30 to move very smooth. There was no real sticking point to it. So now we're gonna drop the weight down and do that 3x7 I talked about earlier. It's supposed to be at an RP of 6, so this is supposed to fly by. It's not supposed to be anything too difficult. So we're gonna focus on technique, focus on form, execution. We wanna be undeniable on the next meet, man. Like, it's really not that far out. It's about 4 months away. And that's really not that far. Like, 4 months is gonna fly by. Once November's basically over, then we have December, January, February, and then we have like a little bit of March. But at that point, we're gonna be peaking into that meet. So, I mean, it's a quick turnaround, but you know, we just gotta get the work in that we can. So, every session counts at this point. It's like prep kind of started already, but it hasn't exactly started, if you know what I'm talking about. So, 3x7 RP is 6, 315 pounds. Let's get it. Finish up with the workout. It was pretty good, actually. It was like I ended up doing chest and triceps. There we go, chest and triceps. So right now I'm actually dropping off a pair, or Max ordered some stuff from the last launch, and then I'm also picking up some stuff for Black Friday, because Black Friday is actually coming today. Wait, Black Friday, when is Black Friday? It's like on Friday, right? Bro, that has to be the dumbest thing I have fucking said on this channel. Okay, Black Friday is this Friday. So I'm picking up my stuff from Outfleet that's coming out this Black Friday launch for Outfleet. It's gonna be absolutely ridiculous. So I'm gonna pick that up and then obviously showcase what we have coming, like when I get back to the crib. But yeah, gonna drop that off, pick up the Outfleet gear that's dropping this Black Friday, because Black Friday is on Friday. So yeah. Yeah, kind of scared. Okay, so Max is, I don't think he's here. So I'm just gonna go ahead and put his package right here, and then hopefully my stuff is here. Hello?
Yes.
Oh my gosh, scared me. What's up, Becca? What's up, Christian? I thought you weren't here.
Bro, you need your package.
Yeah, that's why I came to pick up.
Hey, yes, sir. Kelsey should be next door. She actually has it for you.
Kelsey said that it was here.
Oh, she made it wrong.
Yeah, she texts out like when
oh,
she.
Oh, bro, you're not ready for this shit.
I'm on camera right now, by the way. So.
Oh, okay.
I just want to make sure it's not anything. It's like. Do you know the vibes?
Oh man, how's this dude doing?
Nutless.
Oh, he got fixed.
Yeah.
Damn. Yeah, kind of
hot. Oh my god.
I was like letting it close, so the guys here are going out. But yeah, okay, so we got the package here, or like the bag here from the launch that's coming this Friday. So obviously I'll be like running through a whole shoot tomorrow just to show you guys the vibes, show you guys what's coming. And that's basically it, man. This Black Friday launch, like I was just talking to Christian, is gonna be absolutely big for Alphalete. So if you have ever wanted anything from Alphalete, I would say that this is your opportunity to get that stuff now because it's gonna be selling for the very, very low, like it's gonna be low price, right? He was telling me they have stuff as low as like $8, so you might as well just go to the website, ball out, you know what I'm saying, use your boy's code Russ Wolf for that support, you know what I'm saying, show a little love, you know what I mean, it's holiday season. But seriously, if you've ever wanted Alphalete stuff and you felt that like maybe the price is a little bit too high, Black Friday is obviously your opportunity to capitalize in that moment and get something that you always wanted. So shout out to the gang, it's gonna be a big drop. Excited about this, but once again, tomorrow I'll show you guys the vibes and show you guys what it's looking like. So I'll catch you guys tomorrow. Yeah, no, yeah, okay, all right, peace. What's that meme with the girl? It's like she's like crying and she's like this, not like that. All right. Play a song on Rock Band, expert level, drums, you know the vibes. Okay, I'm done listening to Blink-182. It's funny because like I was gonna make fun of the music, but I fuck with Blink-182, so I can't do it. I can't even do it. I like Travis Barker, one of the greatest drummers of all time. Come on, man, stop playing with the boy. But it's Tuesday. I'm in a much better mood than yesterday. Yesterday was just weird. I just came inside the gym. I was very like, just. Is the word lethargic? I just felt weird. I just felt very sluggish. But today, a little bit more higher energy. I took pre-workout to the face. I want to take another scoop. Honestly, I want to get hyped up. We have a heavy squat single. So last week we did 675 pounds. I'm thinking we'll probably repeat that. If not, maybe do like 695. Maybe 700 if we're feeling it. But we got to stay within the RPE range of 7. So let's get to it, man. Wearing that new, you know what I'm saying, that Alphalete, the Aspire t-shirt that's dropping. Will be available like Friday at a very discounted price. Check out the details right here. Where's that? Your Alphalete on the side. You got learn more, do more, be more on the back. Come on, man. Look at this stretch. Look at that. Doesn't lose the integrity of the shirt though. Okay, bros, get to work.
Before I take a nap, before I go to sleep. Count 100 racks while I'm praying on my knees. Chop up with the 50 wicker, make the bitch breathe. Never snitching, never switching, nigga, please. Throwing up the cheese, throwing up a couple peas. Ain't going outside, nigga, you don't read. Everybody having paper, ain't nobody greedy. That is in the room, I deny him, they cannot eat. Denying. I keep talking about her cause I'm missing pistol peas. Need you on my shoulder, you an angel, watch the demons.
What I thought would be the top set. So, this is going against my better judgment. I hit 635 pounds for the last single that you guys just saw, but it just didn't, like, on camera looks fine, but like, even do want to test it to it. In person, it looked kind of off, like it just didn't look like my usual 635. And it's like, this is where it becomes tough because it's like, I can't tell if it was like my technique or if it was just like, I don't have it today. And I'm like erring on the side of technique. Like, I feel like if I do this next set right here, it's gonna move better than the 635. So it's like, this is where you have to be able to kind of like, trust yourself as an athlete. Like, you have to be able to humble yourself, but at the same time, you gotta know that's like, maybe that was technique. And I'm erring on the side, maybe that's technique. I'm fine with like, having a fucked up single for today's workout. If it is that, like, I'll always trust myself as an athlete, but at the same time, like, I just can't sit on 635 as a single for today's workout because I just feel like I'm way stronger than that. Like, that shit has been the today's single. I hit 675 last week and it moved relatively easy. I know you're supposed to take it day by day, but it's like, it's tough because I just feel like it was a technique thing and just like the way I got inside the hole, I don't know. So we'll see. I'm just waiting for someone to like pull up and give me a spot. Because, like, you can't trust many people in the gym when it comes to, like, spotting for, like, a squat. It could go wrong very quickly. So I'm trying to see someone that I can rely on real quick. But we got 630. We got 675 on the bar right now. This should move a lot better than 635. If I'm wrong, I'm wrong. But I'm betting that I'm going to be right. I knew it was my technique. I knew it was my technique. That moved way easier than the 635. Sometimes you gotta trust yourself. Hey, you was nervous, huh? Hey, yo, I'm not gonna lie. Like, I just had to talk my shit. Like, I had to go through the mirror, do my shit, have that confidence to stay within myself. Cause, like, seriously, though, like, shit. That could have been bad. I couldn't find a spotter, so I'm like, fuck, let me just go by myself. Hey, I'm good, though. Sometimes I just gotta roll the dice. Okay, so now we have back down sets with, we have sets of 8. So I put 565 pounds on the bar. Now, my last prep, I said I don't want to get anything lower than 585 pounds, which is 6th place. But, you know, as I'm working my way back up from competing, I want to gradually get back into that 6th plate range for sets of, like, 6 plus. So today is the first set of 8 that I have on my program. The next week's going to be another set of 8. So I'm targeting to hit 585 pounds for at least a set or two of 8 next week. So we're gradually working our way into that. We don't want to jump straight into it. So this should move decently, right? And next week I should be able to move up to 585 pounds. So it's just kind of like easing my body into it. There's no rush to get into that 585 pound range for sets of 6 plus. So yeah. Woo! 3 sets, man. Let's make it count. Six plus, like 8 reps. What you do? Rep number 1, you get out of the hole, you're like, bro, I got 7 more of these things? That's how I be feeling. Set number 2, completed. One more set.
You gon' die. You gon' die. Yeah, what it mean? What it mean? I'm outside, pop out game with the team. That's in the casket, dog. We ripping the past, they ask me. I'm in the bag, looking like a dragon. I'm cooking, I'm ashy. I fish to the demon, I drag. Demon, bro, magic.
not sure what it was. But that set of eight, those sets of eight just murdered me. I don't know what's going on.
I feel roasted. The workout's been completed.
I think I see the light. It's blinding.
Okay, I've now cooled down from that extraneous squat session that we just had. So right now we're shooting all the stuff for Alphalete that once again is going to be available for a super discounted price this Friday for the Black Friday sale. So right now this is the Aspire black short sleeve shirt. I'm going to be changing it to some of the other stuff. They got it in red as well, which I think is dope. Yeah, short sleeve. So there's a lot of things dropping once again. Alphalete.com or AlphaleteAthletics.com Friday. Use my discount or use my code RussellWillis to support me. But we're gonna shoot for that, get some pictures ready. It's kinda like market on my Instagram page. And that's gonna be it for today's session. Okay, it's literally been 2 hours since the last time I talked to you guys. I was taking care of some things in the area. Yeah. That's all I'm gonna say for right now. But this video is gonna be coming to an end. I hope you guys enjoyed the training footage. You know, once again, the Black Friday sale for Alphalete will be going live on Black Friday, which would be like Thursday at 12 a.m. or 11:59, one of those. Obviously, use my code RussellWill to support me on the back end. Don't forget, BPN also is coming out with their Black. Honestly, every company that I'm sponsored by they're having their own Black Friday sale. So head on to their websites if you guys want to save 40, 50. Whatever percent off if you guys are into that kind of stuff. But I want to thank you guys for the support, man, on the hoodie launch, all that kind of stuff. There has just been like a big demand for me to kind of like push, go harder. Like, I don't even want to be corny right now, but it's like coming from where I started and like thinking about where I was doing YouTube when I first initially started picking up a camera and stuff like that, I'm like, damn, this is what I dreamt of. Like, this is kind of the idea that I had in mind way back like 3 or 4 years ago when I first started my YouTube channel. I'm like, I want to provide something for a community of people that kind of understand the vibe that I'm giving off. Like, whether it's like get better today inside of the gym or like your workspace, whatever you're doing, just pushing to become a better you. And I'm happy that I've kind of like helped establish a community where it makes people feel a lot more comfortable to do that. People hit me up on Twitter, people hit me up on Instagram all the time and like, yo Russ, like your content has helped me, you know, be a lot more comfortable inside of the gym, or whenever I'm studying for a test, I think about Get Better Today. Like, I think about you saying that inside of your head. So, just want to thank you guys for that. So, I'm going to go ahead and tune out the video, coming to an end. You know what I'm saying? Like always, if you guys like today's video, please like, comment, share, and subscribe. Get better today. I'm out.
Before I take a nap, before I go to sleep, count 100 racks while I'm praying on my knees. Chop up with the 50 wicker, make the bitch breathe. Never snitching, never switching, nigga, please. Never throwing up.